for subscribing to our channel, for finding time to come and watch the video. Thank you to those who are yet to do so. Please just hit the red button again. Just subscribe, okay? Encourage our YouTube channel by subscribing. And please do what to follow us on social media like Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Pinterest. P Love Beauty Palace, and P Love Kitchen. We also have another channel for cooking. So if you want to learn some healthy recipes, just follow P Love Kitchen 17. Thank you. So today, I want to discuss something that is so unique, something that is so crucial, that may be, you know, not seen as something serious. And that is settling in your new home. Settling in your new home after wedding. You know, most times people just prepare for marriage and over prepare, only to get there and discover that marriage is so unpredictable. Really, marriage is unpredictable, but sometimes people like fantasize. Yeah, this is what I want to do, this is what I want to achieve, this is what I want my spouse to be like, this is what I want my children to be like, this is what I want my in-laws to be like, and oh my God, we prepare a lot. But sometimes, some of those things don't come true. Yeah. So today I have just a few tips that can help a newly married person, you know, to adjust in her new home, especially the ladies. After you have left your parents' home and moved to your husband's house, things will not be the same as they have been. And so I have three things I have listed out today, which has to do with what your emotion. You have to what adjust emotionally. You have to adjust emotionally. Then spiritually, you have to adjust spiritually. And then physically, you have to adjust. Someone may say, what do you mean by emotionally you have to adjust? I've had issues where some people are like, oh my God, this marriage, is it what it's all about? I'm missing my parents, I'm missing my home, and blah, 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 stuff like that. You have to make up your mind to adjust in your new home emotionally. You have to let your emotions know that this is a new place and this is mine. Yeah, it's not just a new place, it is mine. Marriage is for life. So that new home is yours. It's yours. That's the new place that God has given to you now to build for Him. And I hope your marriage is working out for the glory of God, not for selfish reasons. No, no, no. God is the institutor of what's marriage. And so everything we do, we must do it to bring Him honor. Your marriage must be a place of honor for God. It must be a place where God comes and He feels at home because it is His. And marriage is the only institution that we get the certificate. The only school we get certificate before we enter into it. And the Bible says that God hates divorce. So you have to take it serious. With that certificate, you have to work it out. The Bible says you will work out your salvation with fear and trembling. The same way you have to work out your marriage, okay? You have to work out your marriage. And so today, what I mentioned about the emotion, moving out of your parents' home into your husband's home, things may not be the same. You know, the way things are and the way maybe you are being spoken to emotionally, the way that you feel and the love you get from your parents and your siblings and those people around you, or maybe you have changed your state to another state and it's like, oh my God, emotionally you are being drained. You have to make up your mind to do what? Adjust properly. Emotionally, you have to make up your mind to accept the new reality. Yeah, that is a new reality and it's a life one. The one that you're going to spend a longer time with is a reality that has come to stay. So you have to emotionally what? Embrace it. All right? Okay. So the next one has to do with what? Spiritually. Are you a Christian woman? Oh my God. This is where you walk. Okay? As you get into your new home, your husband's home, it's time for you to do what? Do some spiritual work. You have to walk spiritually. It is time to do what? Take authority over that environment, over the home where you are, over the backgrounds of your husband's place, even your own places. And then it's time to embrace God more and say, Father, this is my home. I've stepped in. Please, I lay it all at your feet. Please take over. Please take charge. Okay? It's the time for you. You know, when you're building a house, you lay foundation for that house. You don't wait for the house to finish building. No. So that time you are stepping into your matrimonial home, that new time you're entering, it's a time for you to do what? Lay solid foundation spiritually. It's time for you to pray for your children that are yet to come. It's time for you to pray for a relationship with your husband. It's time for you to pray for your in-laws. I know during courtship, if you have not watched the video I posted before about the things to expect, things to do during courtship, please watch it. It will help you a lot. During courtship, there are times you have discussed all of this, but as you have stepped in, this is now my home. I'm in already. It is now mine. You begin to lay a fresh foundation. Begin to agree on what you want. Begin to pray about it. Begin to pray for, you know, the way people you want to receive in your home, the way they take authority, take charge, speak things over the behavior of your children, over their future, over your future, over your love relationship, that you will not be drained. Because trust me, there's sometimes that things may happen, be like, did I make mistakes? So that's the time for you to begin to pray for those things as you have stepped your foot in that home, and also begin to pray for every other thing that have existed there before you stepped in that does not give God glory. Say, as I have stepped in, I'm taking charge. You are no longer welcome in this home. You begin to send out things that need to be sent out. You don't have to wait till when you begin to have a thought or things begin to happen, then you begin to pray. No, it's time for you to begin and ask God to reveal things to you. If you're sensing the spirit, it's time God to reveal some spiritual things that must have happened in the background of your new home that your husband may not be able to have told you about, or your spouse may not be able, your wife had not been able to tell you about during time of courtship. But as both of you have come together, you begin to pray about them and begin to pray the affliction of the past. You know, things that have happened in my wife's place or my husband's place, it will not repeat itself. That is the time to pray. Spiritually lay the foundation of your home. You take control. You know, life is more spiritual than it is physically. But sometimes we focus on the physical aspect of it. It is more spiritual. You know, the spiritual controls the physical. It's a popular saying. So you have to lay solid foundation for your home as you get into the marriage home. Then again, the physical aspect of it is what? It's time for you to begin to, you know, you see things, those things that you have anticipated for, they may not begin to appear like you have wished for them, you have fantasized for them, you have, oh my God, I want my home to be this one and this one, oh, go for vacation and stuff like that. My dear, it's time to calm down. Right there. It's time to calm down and do what? A proper work of asking yourself some certain questions and begin to what? Align with the things that you can align with. It's time for you to what? Tolerate things that you can tolerate. It's time for you to overlook some things that you have to overlook. Yes, it could be your spouse's hygiene level. It could be poor. During courtship, those things can be, oh no, everybody is coming out looking good. But now you are in. The real thing is being what? Unveiled. Maybe someone who does not like brushing teeth. Some people don't like, maybe they brush today, tomorrow they will not brush, and it's like, ew, what is this? It's not time for you to keep quiet and say, let me just leave him. I just entered. Let me just overlook her. We just entered so she doesn't feel that. No. That is the time to do what? Handle such issues. It's time to discuss. I've had to counsel people who, what? When they got into the marriage, you hear the lady saying, I just got in, so I didn't want to talk. He was doing it then as a married though, and I said, let me just keep quiet with time. And that with time, they begin to, so this part's like, why are you complaining now? You came in and you met this and you said nothing. And trust me, I support such a person. Why did you keep quiet? Why did you wait? Why wait after years? Why wait? Why waste time? Then you begin to talk. So those things that you are seeing at that time that is not working, you know, the way that you know it will not help your marriage. It's time for you to call your spouse, both of you sit down together and discuss them. It's time for you to call your spouse, both of you sit down and, you know, work out things. This is where we can do this and it's better for us. This is where we can do this and it's better. It could even be sex-wise. Some of your spouse's way of having sex, or maybe the person demands too much, or the person is not satisfying you, or you're not finding pleasure, whatever. It's time for you to speak out. Don't say, oh, I just got in, let's just manage. And then after like 5 months, you now speak out. I heard of a lady, she was complaining so much. She said that, imagine, he cannot satisfy me. I've just been bearing it. I said, and why did you keep waiting now? And by the time she started talking, the husband is like, why are you telling me? All this while you have been enjoying it. I told her, I said, and I blame you for that. You know, if you had spoken out at that early time, we have still found a solution together. Why keep quiet? Why do you want to wait? Something that you know that is for a lifetime. This is the time you are building your foundation. Please, I'm speaking to those who are just entering it now. This is time for you to build your foundation. You have to look physically, emotionally, and spiritually what settle in. The things you need to talk about, is it the sex area? Is it monetary wise, where he's spending or she's spending? Some men will keep quiet. Their wife is spending so much on the way she's not supposed to spend, and or the way they don't like it. Instead of telling her, I don't like the way you are spending, you spend so much, or you are wasteful, they keep quiet. After a while, after like months or years, one of the days when they can't take it anymore, they blow out and they begin to shout, why are you wasting money? You like spending unnecessarily, and the woman is like, where is this coming from? And the woman is like, I'll be keeping quiet. Why keep quiet? Why keep quiet and wait until the time that you explode? And most times those explosions end dangerously, which is not good. Please speak out that early time, okay? Discuss the things you have to discuss. Your wife, she's spending unnecessarily. Hi, honey, the way you spend, you know, we have projects ahead of us. This is how we can do for now. Retire when money begins to, okay, good and fine. Your wife will have to watch, because at least tomorrow when you talk about it again, she will not feel that you are just cooking up things. She know that already you have said talking about it from the onset. Then your husband is tired, that is not hygienic, it's not clean, it's not, you know, it's not well kept. You begin to tell him and say, please, you have to try also to put hands in keeping this things properly, because when children begin to come, I'll have more work. We will have more work. Okay? You don't have to wait. When he comes back from work, he throws his shoes there, throws his shirt there, and his laptop is on the dining table, and you eat food, you overlook it, and you carry it and go and keep, and like that, you keep quiet. By the time children are coming and the work is so much on you, you explode. Why are you so dirty? Why are you? Discuss it at any time. Now, it could be what people around you, it could be your spouse, siblings, it could be your in-laws, your relatives, people, his friends that come around. The way they behave towards you, the way they are doing things, it's not acceptable. Remember, you came from two different homes. You had different upbringings. So yes, it's understandable that you have the way you are brought up. You have the pattern of living your life. So now his friends are coming and they are doing otherwise. Don't just say, let me not talk. Let the friends not see me as a bad person. Let my husband and my wife not see me as a bad person. You keep quiet. And one of the days when the friend now come after a few months, like, they do the same and you are all over the whole place, so mad and angry and pissed off. It's time for you to tell your spouse, please, this, your friends, this they are doing, this they are that, the time of their visiting is not good, the time of their, you talk about it, discuss it. It will not help our marriage. I remember what helped me and my husband when we got married. Really. We told ourselves, from so and so time, we don't pick up. We don't pick up from so and so time. And with time, our families got to understand that. Because when my son, I said, please, this is the wrong time to call. It's an emergency. By this time, we don't receive calls. With time, it's, you know, sunk in. Had they been okay, we just kept quiet. And this person is picking call by, let's say, 12 a.m. in the morning, and you're like, what is this? That's it. Where the person must have been living his or life, because mostly men, when they are still single, as bachelor, they receive calls from their family, from their friends, and they just sleep off on the phone and all that. Now he's married, he has to adjust again, and you have to help him. You have to help the partner that, you know, needs that help. It's time to physically help each other, the things that you are seeing. Work together in putting your home in order. Find diplomatic way to relate with the friends, to handle the relatives, to handle the family, the siblings, and everyone that is around, your in-laws. Find a diplomatic way. That's the time to do what? Make things to blend well. Make things to blend well. Some people, mostly men, maybe they are the ones that are breadwinner of their families, and you are in now. The man needs to understand that he's building a new home, and you have to, like, what, respectfully and diplomatically begin to get that into him. Let him know that, see, honey, we are starting a new life, and then he gets to know it. Because if you don't, you keep quiet, and, you know, calls are coming, both the ones that are necessary and unnecessary are coming like that, and things are going, and tomorrow you are in need, and he says, you, I have to do this. And when you insist, it's like you are becoming what, selfish, without the person knowing that you have been bearing that in your mind all along. It could even be the woman's side, where you give your parents, your siblings, your friends anyhow, and the husband doesn't like that, he keeps quiet. Why keep quiet? Speak out then. Don't wait till time for things overblow. Don't wait for things to escalate. Don't wait for things to become so unbearing for you before you explode. Those times, it may not end up well. It may be so awkward that you will not like it. So please, what's my advice today? For the newly wedded, in settling, you have to settle emotionally, physically, and spiritually. Yes, it could be other areas. So please, I want to hear from you. Are you married for long and you had your experiences, your fair share of the experience? Please drop your comments and let us know how you were able to settle in your new home. And any suggestion, I will appreciate it. Any advice, I will appreciate it. Leave a comment, like, and share this video. please subscribe, please subscribe to my channel. I love you so much and God bless you. Like I said before, make sure your home is bringing God honor. Make sure your home is bringing God praise. Till I come your way next time, I'm sleeping love. God bless you.